Good morning, students. Today, yesterday already we have started the lesson. Second, it is animal rearing, and also I made you write them some animal things also in page number 15 and 16, and you written and from the lesson about this animal rearing. In the lesson yesterday, I told you about the mating of the animals. Yesterday, I told you how all the animals they gathered in the forest and they discussed and they met each other and they discussed about the birthday of the daughter of lion. They discussed about the birthday of the lion's daughter. Birthday of lion's daughter, and finally they came to decision that without food and all, without rain and without food, there was shortage of food in the forest. So what they done is. This birthday was postponed and to next year. So the birthday of king's daughter was not possible due to shortage of the food in the forest. So they decided to celebrate in the next year. So this was about the discussion of the meeting with the each other. So this was about the decision taken by the animals. So now, yesterday I told you and also made you write some names of different animals from page number 15 and 16. You have written already cow, tiger, dog, crow, buffalo, elephant, sheep, deer, cat, snake, hen, chita and all. So already you have written the names of this animals from page number 15 and 16. Now today you are going to write the names of some domestic animals and wild animals. So take down in your classwork. First, today you are ready with your textbook means you take care in the textbook only. In the page number 15 here, upper side, you can write the names of the animals. So, name your domestic animals right here. Name your domestic and wild animals. Name the domestic and wild animals. Name the domestic and wild animals in the story. Write their name here. Write their name here. So this is the question in page number 10. Name the domestic animals and wild animals in the story and write their name here. So the first one, domestic animals, D-O-M-E-S-T-I-C, domestic animals one side and wild animals other side. Wild animals. So you must supposed to know what are domestic animals and what are wild animals. See, domestic animals means the animals which we rear in our house. Domestic animals means the animals which we rear in our house. Rear means sakar. The animals which we rear in our house are called as domestic animals. Understood? And wild animals means the animals which we do not rear in our house. These are called as, these are called wild animals. We are not rearing these animals. Understood? Because they are wild. They are very dangerous and they are very, we cannot go near them. And they are said as, they are said to be wild animals. Understood? Like a lion, tiger, cheetah, snake. Understood? They come under wild animals. And domestic animals like cow, buffalo, goat, sheep, dog, they come under domestic animals. Understood? Now take down the examples for domestic animals from the story itself. Now domestic animals from the story. First you can write here cow, C-O-W, cow. It is the domestic animal, cow. Next, cat, rabbit, cow, cat, rabbit. Monkey, and deer. So cow, cat, rabbit, monkey, deer, they come under domestic animals. Understood? These can be reared in our house. Now, so here, which are the wild animals here, sir? They are figure on this side, in this column. It is lion. Next, snake. A snake is snake. Cheetah. Elephant. Fox. So these are the few few examples for wild animals. Understood? Which we do not rear them. Understood? We do not rear these animals because they are wild animals. Understood? Only we rear animals like cow, cat, rabbit, monkey, and dog. We rear in our house. Understood? So these are called domestic animals and these are called as wild animals. Understood? So now you can take down in your classwork, in your textbook, page number 15. In the column, you can write in the domestic animals in the domestic column and wild animals in the wild animals column. So these are the animals names you can take down. And till then, I'll be going to next page. You can look cow, cat, rabbit, monkey, deer, lion, snake, cheetah, elephant, fox. So you can take down your textbook. let us go to page number 16. I think you might have finished the writing this in the textbook. You may refer in the story also, in page number 12, you can refer different items. Those who are there in the story, you should have. Now I have finished the writing, completed writing. Writing is over. Now let me go to next page. Completed writing. Now next, look page number 16. Which of the animals from these pictures you have here in your house? Write them in the blank. Which of the animals from these pictures you have here in your house? Write them in the blank. So let us write in page number 16. You can write here the animals which we can be reared. You have reared. Ashuda, let us write which can be reared in our house. So already you have written in the textbook. And now again continue page number 16. Which animals have been reared in your house? Write them. Right here. Which of the animals from these pictures have you reared in your house? Question mark. Write them in the blank. So this is a question. So we are going to write the name of animals here: cow, dog, D-O-G, dog, buffalo, sheep. Cat, hen, and also one parrot and all can be here in our house. So these are the few animals which we rear in our house. So you can pick up again here that page number 16, you write in this column here. Page number 16, you write the name of animals which we rear in our house. Now let us go to next question if you have completed. So take down in the classwork. First, sit properly and take down the words.
Earphone.
So these are the name of two animals which can be reared. Reared means staff of the daughter. Now let us go to next page. The animals that are reared in the house are called domestic animals. The meaning of the domestic animals is the animals that are reared in our house are called domestic animals. Now let us go to next question. Have you finished writing it? If you have completed it, we go to next question. Next question. Write the name of animals. Write the name of animals. Write the name of. Write the name of. Name of animals. Name of animals. Which you have not reared. Which you have not reared. Which you not reared. Which you not reared. Which you not reared. But live in your house. But live in your house. This is the question here. So now here, see there are some animals which you not rear, which you do not rear, but still they live in our house. There are some animals we do not rear them, but they live in our house. Understood? Some animals which we do not rear, but live in our house. ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳು ಅವು ಅವು ನಾವು ಸಾಕಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅದ್ರ ಸಹಿತ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯೊಳಗೆ ಇರ್ತಾವ. ನಾವು ಅವನ್ನ ಸಾಕಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಸಹಿತ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯೊಳಗೆ ಇರ್ತಾವ. ಅವು ಯಾವಂದ್ರೆ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ ದ ದೋಸ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಸೊ ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ದೇ ನೌ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ lizard, lizard, mosquito, mosquito, lizard, mosquito, take down. Then next ants, 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 rats, 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 cockroach, cockroach, cockroach. Approach, then bed bugs, bed bugs. So these are the two animals. We do not rear them, but they live in our house. We don't rear them, but still they live in our house. Our house. So lizard is one example. Lizard, early mosquito. Sorry, what we call them. Then after mosquito, ants. Ants will be there. Then rats. Here what we call cockroach. Bed bug. So these are the few animals live in our house. Even though we don't rear them, but they live in our house. Now sakleya insecta, prani galu namma mane olige irthirthava. So these are the few animals live in our house. Now last thing, take down your textbook ka. So complete your writing work. So already time is up. So let us continue tomorrow with the next page. And now you can till then you can read the words which are given here. Understood? You read the few animals name and try to understand. So tomorrow let us continue. Thank you for your attending the class.